Wow. This is really cool.
So we saw this video on Facebook, and we're up here just north of Knoxville, about 30, 40 miles in a place called Greasy Hollow. And we saw this video about this older gentleman that used to own a general store that was very well known up here. And it was in his family since the 1920s, early 1900s. And he used to sell case knives in his general store. So what we wanted to do is we've actually got a very special case knife that we've got engraved for him that we're going to present him with. And we're just going to kind of talk to him and want to see if he's got some old stories from back in the day. So this store ran from the early 1900s on through 1990 is when it actually closed down. And it's been in his family the entire time. I believe he's about to turn 96 this year. And just a really, really cool old guy that we want to present him with this special knife here. How are you doing, Mr. Ralph?
I'm doing good.
It is nice to finally meet you. I'm TC.
Who?
TC from Smoky Mountain Knife Works.
TC.
Yes, sir.
Okay, come on in.
Yes, sir.
TC. Sit down, see where you...
Me and Isaac here, we work in the social media department doing all of their marketing and videos and stuff like that, so... talking about all their knives and all the new stuff that comes out and all that kind of stuff. Now, we heard about this video and saw you on Facebook.
Yeah.
And saw that you had a general store here that you used to sell some case knives in.
Yeah.
For a few years.
That store you passed by, right? Uh-huh. That very old store.
Now, when did that store open?
When did it open? Well, let's see. My daddy used to live in that old store when he first got married. And he lived in it and built that house up there on the other side of the store on the same side. And then when he got that done, he moved in it and they started a store. And another old one they built this and it was right there now, and they had started in an older one. And that's how long it's been. It started in about 1922.
That's amazing. So that's been in your family since it started.
Oh, yeah.
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 And you you ran it for quite a while, didn't you?
Yeah. My grandpa started out with it. He run it for years. I don't know how many years he run it. But he got disabled, had to have his leg took off, and got disabled to work in the store, run it. And he quit, and then my daddy took it over. Of course, he already owned half of the store. He bought it to start with. My daddy did. But I run it for 23 years myself.
And you closed it down in 1990, is that right?
94.
94?
I believe that's when it was, 94, about round about that.
So how did you get into selling case knives?
I just buying them here and there and going to buying cases and reselling them.
Was there any other brands?
I never did have a dealer.
No?
I mean, it told them to me. I just bought them wherever I could get them.
You bought some wholesale. You talked about that one time that Sheila, what's her name, Sheila Jesse?
Sheila Jesse.
What?
They know Mari.
Oh, really?
Sheila worked for, I get to talk to her. Do you ever remember getting some? You did get some knives from Case directly one time through Sheila, one of Lisa's
Sheila,
friends.
Remember Sheila, my friend Sheila?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I remember that.
She got you some knives one time somehow, didn't she? Yeah. So, you just get them wherever you could get them, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Because they'd sell, wouldn't they?
Well, back in the day, that's how a lot of people got started. That's how our founder got started. I mean, they would, you know, buy and sell them at knife shows out of the trunk of their car and stuff like that. And they'd go to little, you know, knife shows here and there and flea markets and stuff, and they'd buy some and then go back to the store and sell them.
Yeah.
That's how it was done back then, wasn't it?
Well, I sold a little bit of everything. He even sold bootleg fireworks, didn't you?
Yeah.
That's a pretty cool story right there. We heard about that out of the back room back there.
I used to bootleg.
Well, they brought you a little gift here.
We got something for you right here.
Okay. Well, you got a knife.
We wanted to bring you a case knife.
A case knife.
Since you had a little bit of experience selling those, we wanted to bring one for you to keep.
That's a good deal, buddy. That's a champion knife. A case is.
Yes, it is.
Huh?
That one's a little special too. We did something a little special to that one.
Let me see what you got here. Oh yeah, them bone handles.
They are. Those are jig bone handles.
Two blades. Blade niche in.
Nice trapper pattern.
I think they put something on them blades. Open it up there. They might have wrote something on them blades for you.
I don't know if I know, but no.
Greasy Hollow Memories.
Ain't that what it says?
Yep.
That's what it says. The light, you're right. The light's shining on a little bit.
See, it's hard to see. So you get it a certain way.
Greasy Holler Memories. That's the video series we've been making here about all your memories here in Greasy Holler.
Smoky
Mountain Knife Works. And it's got our logo on it there.
Yeah.
So they wanted to give you a knife in honor of you selling case knives out there at your little store. And
yeah, I did. I used to sell them. Buying wherever I could.
There ain't no better stories than hearing those old stories like that. That's as good as it gets right there, is being able to hear folks like you tell the stories about how you used to sell case knives and how you grew up here.
What kind of, do you remember what kind of case knives you sold the most? What kind of handle people liked? Or single blade, double blade?
Three blades?
Mostly.
Stockman
pattern?
Now, I heard there's some other things that you've encountered, too, that's kind of sharp that is not a knife, though. I heard a story about a chainsaw.
Chainsaw?
Yeah, you had an issue with a chainsaw. You got in a fight with a chainsaw?
Oh, yeah. That's the chain of a chainsaw.
A chainsaw, that's pretty sharp right there, too. It'll take that finger right off, won't it?
Yeah, I had a little bitty pole about that big in my hand and was just had it up like that and was holding one hand to saw another. And I come down on it and that saw went run right down that stick and cut that finger off.
Do you have any old case knives still?
Oh, no, I don't.
You got one in your pocket probably right now.
Yeah, I've got one.
What you got?
Get it out. I've got a little case in my pocket. Right there's my case now.
Nice.
Three or 4 years, something. I don't know. Maybe longer.
Oh, yeah.
That ain't never been sharpened or nothing.
Can you tell what year that one is?
This one's going to be 90s, judging by that tang stamp.
90?
Sometime in the 90s.
I like them like a small knife, keep them weighting me down.
Yeah, I understand that.
Oh, you got a big knife, thank you.
This is the one I carry. So I do some work for Dolly Parton Stampede down there. I ride horses. And so I've got this queen knife that is actually got a hoof pick on it right there so that I can pick out my horse's feet before we get started with the show and do all that stuff. So I can pick out his feet and make sure he's clean and good to go. And it's got a all on it right there.
Yeah.
I can do some trimming if I need to. So that's what I carry on days that I go out riding horses.
Is there any other knife brands you remember?
Yeah, he's got some in here on the wall that he's got a collection of.
Oh, yeah, I have all kinds of knives.
What other brands did you?
Them's Bokers.
Bokers? Okay. I knew it'd be Bokers.
I got a thing in there in that room right there.
We're here at the old general store that Ralph used to run that's been in his family since 1922. And we're going to go in here in just a minute, talk to Ralph a little bit. Now, I want you to close your eyes and think back in time, back to when this was a popping spot. You know, you got the old men sitting out in the rocking chair, leaned up against the front of the store. You got the guys on inside, you know, gathered around the potbelly stove in the wintertime, telling stories. And it's just a really cool environment and really cool memories that we want to take you back to right now. Let's head on inside.
Yeah.
Okay. Wow. This is really cool. This is beautiful. I love this.
This is a mold store, but this started out way back.
Got the old display counter and everything right there. Ralph, so this was one of your showcases that you had here that you sold all kinds of stuff out of. You had knives in it too, case knives and stuff like that. What all kinds of stuff did y'all sell here?
Everything.
A little bit of everything, huh?
Yeah, with groceries.
And I tell you what, it's really neat looking around here because I can see, you know, memories and things that I remember from when I was a kid, like the Charlie Daniels skull poster right up there. And you were talking earlier about the cheese boxes that you got up here.
Oh, yeah. That's where I sold cheese. I'd sell them. Cheese sandwiches and blown in stuff, and I just sold the boxes up there on top.
Right, once you got all the cheese out of it.
That ain't near all of them.
Right, no, absolutely not. There was plenty of that stuff. And of course, I imagine in the wintertime, everybody gather around this potbelly stove right here and tell stories.
This old shore fever.
All right. This is where everybody come to congregate, wasn't it?
Yeah.
This is where you heard how everybody was doing and
yeah. They'd be people come sit all day.
What year is on that dollar bill?
That one looks like 1923 is the year on that dollar bill right there.
That's about when they opened the store here, so it could have been there ever since it's been opened.
That's an old one right there.
Yeah, that's an old one, them old big book deals.
Yeah, that was before they changed the size of them and everything, yeah.
Well, Ralph, thank you for your time.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you for spending some time with us. And I tell you what, we've seen the outpouring of support from this community.
Yeah.
People, memories all over this place.
So folks, that was a lot of fun getting to talk to and meet Ralph. We want to thank him and his family so much for letting us come and talk to him, and especially for letting us in the store too. I got to say, it's really cool getting to hear memories and stories like that from times gone by. And if you want to hear more stuff like this, definitely check out Appalachian Homes, People, and Places on Facebook. Appalachian Homes, People, and Places. You're going to see a lot more interviews with Ralph himself, as well as other folks from around the East Tennessee area, and get to see this kind of, it's very similar to a Heartland series of the days of old. So you get to see some really cool history of this area, and it's a really neat thing to see and watch. So check that out. Also, if you've got any stories like this, let us know in the comments down below. If you want us to film you next, absolutely let us know in the comments down below, because we're looking for classic stories like this of people that, you know, have experience and sold case knives, old general stores like this. This is the stuff that we love to hear. And let us know in the comments down below if you've got some stories like that. Folks, as always, it's been me, TC, here with Smoky Mountain Knife Works. And remember, if it cuts like an old case dealer, then we carry it.
And we're here in Greasy Hollow. Let me do that over again.
Hey, you know what? I remember the old days where we all used to sit around the old pot. I love them days.